You guys are good to go whenever you're ready.
Alright, got it's TKO Sage here with TKO Noshmo, and we got Spiral in here.
And wow, these battle of the TKO Titans, I guess. I don't know. You guys haven't fought forever. It's been a very long time.
It's Bayo. So we're gonna have plenty of options to get back on stage. I think he was just kind of doing that just to be like, hey man.
Okay.
That's good damage.
Did you expect that to kill?
Absolutely not.
Okay, I was like, you got really hyped about that, and I was like, that's some solid damage, but not quite enough to get that stun.
Oh, small damage.
Ladder combos by Bayo. What do you call it? Ladder carrying combos?
I don't know. It's auto combo.
I mean, I just want to like, what are they calling that these days?
Sakurai, please.
Yeah. See, that's the thing. You gotta be really careful in matchups against the side boys particularly, because they're gonna be like waiting for a grab opportunity. So baiting out which time, you're gonna have to be very careful on like, you know, when you throw that out, because if they get a grab on you, that's gonna be some heavy damage, even if it's just a throw.
Oh, that's Luki Dookie. That's it. Yep.
Luki and Dookie right
there. Those brain buzz.
What?
Hey, we call it Luki Dookie here.
Whatever.
I get the brain blast. I see the Jimmy Neutron reference.
I got Texas saying that now.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Let's go.
After I commented with a neighbor, he started going.
Let's go.
That's pretty good. Got a lot of Nair combos there, getting an easy 30% on LRs. Lucas with Rage is actually pretty scary.
It is.
Did you say Range?
Rage.
Oh, I thought you said Range. I was like, oh,
Rage. Rage, my dude. I would say Lucas actually has a pretty good range option.
Like, forward air is really amazing.
Yeah, it's got some pretty good range. But you know what else has good range? That back air.
Yeah, it sure does.
Sour spotless.
But I mean, look at that. Anyways. Still seeing a lot of like neutral exchanges here. Oh, going in for grab conversions with the tether. Oh, he's got it.
This is my kill. No. Okay.
Dude, did you see how close it?
If you had a little bit of rage, it would have killed. Come on.
You're killing me.
It could have.
Man, I got up smashed right there. Oh, that is that was not a good option.
Yeah, he's just a little bit more percent, and he's not looking for
rage. Yeah, so. Melrock is just looking for something. You know, he needs to get like, a strong conversion so he gets into so much. He's gotta win through it. So. See something.
Wouldn't Seals jump?
Wouldn't it have been cheeky if he went up to step down?
What was that?
We're fine.
We're good.
We're still good. We're not good.
That is unfortunate.
Yeah, that's really I was just saying, it would have been really cheeky if he just would have like done the heel slide into down smash. I've seen him do it before, but this time he kind of ended it out.
I agree with him waiting. Like, what? Well, don't tell me. Tell Mikey.
Ow.
Hurt yourself over here, Mom?
I'm okay.
Yelling at commentators.
Zelda's jab is frame 11.
Anyways, let's focus on this set right here.
Well,
so I mean, that was a pretty big turnaround right there. I would say Cheeseballer commanded that lead the whole game.
Yes, he did.
But then he just, you know, flipped around. You gotta play. It's not over until it's over. You gotta get that game.
I'm gonna go the safe way, play some DK. I don't think.
Oh, and he let him go to Town and City. Now, I guess it goes both ways here.
Yeah.
But this is much more dangerous for Bayo than it is for, you know.
Man, it's a matter of how you play it, really. Like, you know, you gotta understand the stage advantages and, like. We're seeing a lot of ledge pressure here today. Like, just overall.
Like, Danby and Hurts in that last game.
Oh my god.
That was ridiculous.
Yeah.
He got, like, 3 kills with the forward air.
I think it was, like, 4.
Was it 4? I don't even know.
Anyway,
it was a lot.
Let's focus.
Once again, maintain a solid lead.
Does anybody here know the ding dong for Bayo? I know it's pretty substantial.
I haven't.
It's like 70 something.
I'm pretty sure we're getting close.
Yeah.
I can kind of tell by the way the Cheeseballer plays, like when it's time.
Because he just starts being on the
edge. Well, he starts playing reactively.
I don't know if that fair was intentional.
Yeah, there we go.
That's what I mean. He waited for the option and then he went in for it.
He did pummel him once or twice, so he was almost in ding dong.
But he had like the plan, so he went for the roll, and then he came up and then he went. I think that's a very smart way to play DK.
Oh, big trouble for me. Yeah. Quick damage.
Yep, that's a fast follow combo right there. Oh, somehow that downward ABK dragged him.
What?
I
I guess it's over.
The flubs.
I guess it's over. Okay. Spigot. All right.
Everybody's wasting their jumps today. I'm hearing Al mess up the...
He just wants to play to game five. I think that's what he's doing.
He's sandbagging every game. He doesn't, like...
No, well, he's just going to win every other.
Well, going into game three, with the advantage, just El Rox, because he did win that first game.
I don't think he's going to switch characters. I think he's going to ride Bayo all the way through. Yeah.
He did talk about wanting to pick Diddy, so...
That is an option, but...
I don't think it's Diddy's polished enough for Juice Ball. Personally.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I mean, it is a bad matchup for DK, but it's like...
It's Joel.
But still, you gotta... I'm not thinking about players. It's just like matchup. It's like this, like, patented own shield on the platform is a cheese baller. You're gonna get your shield, bro. Yeah, he's facing the wrong way, or that would have been a free grab.
Yeah. Unfortunately.
I'm surprised he didn't go for, like,
that forward air hitbox is massive.
Shout out to Kurikani Hammer for enlightening us.
Yeah, see, he was underneath him. Oh, big damage. Ding dong.
I actually should really start counting how much damage each of the throws do for DK. Oh, catching that roll.
Oh, not quite gonna get the stage spike.
Good option using the witch to just kind of like ride up, because he didn't plan on snapping the ledge. He was just trying to cover the two frame option. Maybe trying to extend the combo. But we are gonna get a ding dong.
Wait, no, why are we back on TNC? I mean, I just feel like you wouldn't want to take DK ever.
I honestly, like it was like what I was saying earlier. It's not really the stage, I think, in this particular. It's more of like how you handle neutral.
Right.
Because like, if you're gonna let him like carry you to the top, or let him grab you, you know, then you know, that's your fault. That's not the stage. That's nothing to do with the stage.
Oh no. Is he gonna make it back? Okay. No.
He almost made it back though.
Again in the same fashion.
Elrox will find the stage, guys. He's gonna find it one of these days.
In the same fashion as the first game, doing a downward ABK and dying because that is unfortunate. Twice in a row.
Yeah.
Maybe the tournament nerves starting to get to Elrox.
Probably not. He's just probably flubbing. Oh, he did pick up his character token.
Yeah, you know what? Oh, okay, the duck. All
right, okay, so we can't recover, so we're gonna go
duck.
And I don't see the stage pick. But
it was I definitely know the duck is now.
This is where I agree with you.
Yes.
Because I don't think Duckham has too strong of options.
He wants to do the kill confirm the upper like four in a row. Who's the Duckham player that does that? That did that?
Is it Raito?
Yeah, Raito. And this is how it starts.
I mean, the thing about Duck Hunt is he doesn't really have like easy bread and butter combos.
Yeah.
Like he's got like a throw into camp and stuff, but he's gonna have to play very campy this game to get on that percentage and just play it safe.
That is how you play Duck Hunt. So I
don't know.
Maybe he's trying to hang back a little bit more,
especially against Grappler.
Yeah,
we do not want to rally. Because, like, I mean, he's got can, which could really help him out in those really...
That's a mistake. But he misses the dash grab. I feel like he should have a dash grab, but that's going
to
be ding-dong.
Well, he probably expected it to either power shield it and get a grab, or he didn't expect the forward smash to push him away so much. Kind of like Little Max forward smash, you know? Like, I'm always trying to grab you after it, and I don't do that.
Yeah, it's too much shield push.
So... He's just gonna have to mix up some options.
That was a really interesting exchange right there with the upbeat.
And then that is like the third time he's been able to get
that upbeat. Wow, just letting you know.
Jeez, just having the time of his life right now.
And the Donkey Punch. This is a DK Giant Punch.
Oh no. I think he was rearing up that if he upbeat prematurely, he's gonna die.
I think he should have done a B reverse down B.
What?
Okay.
I don't know. What is going on?
What is happening? Al, remember how you told me in our random money match? It's just too laggy. Right,
well,
you forgot to jump before you did. That's what it was.
I mean, I walked in front of the stage, so Cheese Ball is going to be advancing on.
Yeah.